of the wakes, actually it's consistent eh, sa was sa wake and sa hospital, yung mga hindi wounded but present, hindi nila alam paano i-process yan. So actually I'm calling on the help of all the psychologists and psychotherapists out there, kung pwede yung mga associations ninyo, if you can come together and work out a volunteer mechanism na to reach out. Not just here in Davao, baka pwede yung mga alumni ninyo in Manila or wherever na baka pwede magtulong dito sa Davao, because the mental health has to be addressed.
Ma-remember ni mo itong during our campaign, no? Before election. Dito tanan ni hapon sa katong barbecue sa dito sa Dumoy sa amo. Katong nag-serve sa ato.
Kilid.
Sa kilid. Katong nag-serve sa ato, nana siya sister actually nga naa dito pod sa blast site. So na-appeal siya sa mga wounded.
Sa wounded. Naa siya sa hospital, wala na.
Naa siya sa hospital sa SPMC. Actually dito na ko makita nga grabe ang trauma nila kay siya nasa
ay,
sa Dumoy.
Oo, nabisita ko siya yung nagabarbecue.
Yes.
Na-mention
niya nga dito ka sa iyang sister.
Actually
dito na ko nakita nga traumatic tinuod ang experience even if wala siya sa bomb site, no? Pero igsuon niya na dito, grabe ang trauma sa katong nag-serve sa ato.
Mas kusog ang trauma sa relatives. Mga tao na nadito sa bomb site, na relatives po, na nakitaan nila na ang ilang relative na diha living or injured. That is a greater trauma. But now is the time that Davao has to band together as one and help this community. Kaya ang kining blast, walay gipili. Dato, pobre, tiguang, bata, wala gipili. Muslim, Christian, wala.
Tinood.
Wala gipili. It also did not choose who lives or who dies or who gets wounded. But the fact remains na the blast occurred and it occurred in our community. And it is therefore a community concern. And I hope na ang atong community will also come together and help each other here. Okay? Walay panahon sa politika. Walay panahon sa showbiz. One of the best things that happened na na-observe na ako, September 3 kay, ano, September 2. No? Pag-abot sa September 3, daghan na ang atong mga checkpoint. And sa checkpoint, na-observe na ako na kita, mga taga-Davao, we are very happy and proud that our law enforcement agents are there. Whether that is Task Force Davao or the Philippine National Police, we'll put down our windows. Mag-greet talaga tayo. Mayang buntag, sir. Mayang hapon, sir. So open mo yung glove ko. Baba ka, voluntarily. And nakitaan po na ako, nahin nag-post sa Facebook, hatag po mga Dunkin Donut, mga tubig, pagkaon, hatudyod. And that is the most beautiful thing that I saw a few hours after the bomb. And that kind of community spirit is something that we should cherish and we should be proud of. We don't do that for media.
Yeah.
No, we do that because this happened in our community and we want our community to heal. And that's beautiful. And I think we should support that. And yan ang experience ko, visiting the bomb victims and their families, lipay kaayo sila na we are there as a community.
Pila na ba kung sa kadaghan ba kanila ang ni sumite sa imuhang kinahanglan nila o kanilang mga
tanan.
Psychological,
tanan.
Medical, halos tanan.
Tanan. Tanan, Jude. So far, ang focus is medical, you know, but tanan. Nagtawag ko dito sa Undersecretary of Health, tapos nangay kong tabang. And they promised to send experts from Manila. Pero next week pa yan eh. baka pwede na our community can do something.
It's high time siguro to ask Congressman Coco, no, nga, sa katong imong pamahayag, imong gisulti dito nga nasuko gyud ang mga taga Davao, no, ang Davao niyo sa maong panghitabo dito sa Rojas. Tungod nining mong debate, no, sa mga Davao niyo, mutuo ka ba o masulti ba nimo nga mas nikusog Hinuon ang ilahang suporta kang President Duterte?
Well, the answer is yes. Nag-unify tayo as a community. And of course, ang atong amahan is the President. So, the support for the President is unified because as a community, we are angry, we are confused, we are devastated. Mao nang unifying factor eh. We are hurt as a community. And we look to our leaders, and our leader, our amahan, is Duterte. So, mauna siyang ano, context niya na nisuko ang taga-Davao.
Okay. Nasulti po nimo na Congressman Coco na niyong ka ang kining kung kinsa man tong nagbuhat sa salaod, wa na ni sila'y madaganan, wa na ni sila'y mataguan, gani, niyong ka nga, wa na'y mo, wala na'y gusto pa mo kanang mutago kanila, no, mo kadel, mo kup-kup kanila. Are you referring to the all-out war dito sa mga Abu Sayyaf infested areas?
If they are the bombers, then wala na yan sila mataguan. But yes, I think that the government should not stop in their resolve in fighting terrorism. Us in Congress, mga members of Congress, we have passed multiple resolutions condemning the cowardly act, and we are supporting all efforts to curb terrorism. So, kanang mga terorista diha, they have no safe haven in Davao, they have no safe haven in the Philippines. So, when I released that statement, I was very angry, ha? I was very angry. But karon nagkalma naman ang gamay.
Di maiwasan.
Di maiwasan, siyempre. And yes, we are very firm in our resolve to curb that terrorism. And I don't think that anybody is willing to give them safe haven.
Kakainin daw ng buhay ni
nako
ang mga nambumba sa Rojas Night Market. So ano pong masasabi ni Congressman Jericho Coco Tocranes?
O kang budel fight ata yan. Maging budel pa rin na yan. Suka lang. I think yung atong mga amigo sa Iligan mag-donate pa o gano'n eh. Karang ilang suka dito sa Iligan?
Pinakurat.
Mga sa taga Iloilo, maghatag po doon gano'n.
Ilang version pod
but obviously mga hindi taga Davao hindi nila maintindihan yan. And we have to understand for the benefit of those who don't understand na those statements only prove how hurt our president is. That's ano.
Una na to isugutan, no, katong sunod na tong mga isugutanan, no, kaning state of lawlessness. Una ta mag-break basin duna ka pay gustong ipaabot sa atong mga biktima, no, imong mensahe kanila, Congressman Coco.
Well, actually ang gusto kong i-share is to our community, do what you can to help our victims and the families affected by victims. They are asking for prayers, they're asking for help, and they're asking for healing. So kung sa community natin, we continue to show our support, and we continue to also show our support for our law enforcement agencies, mag-unite lang ta for Davao, for peace in Davao, for peace in Mindanao.
Okay. Sa atong pagbalik, makaigsunan itong isugutan ang deklarasyon sa state of lawlessness. Ilang maghawa kayong balik nito.
Kalampuan, dalatana.
congratulations kay Congressman Carlo Nograles, kay Congressman Coco Nograles. Dako kami og pasalamat nga duha na gyud ang congressman.
Ako nagpasalamat kang Carlo nga nakaabot gyapon sa ikatulong termino.
Congressman Coco Nograles, nagpasalamat mi na hingdaog yung ka. So, congrats.
Congratulations sa duha ka congressman. Ang una si Congressman Carlo Nograles ug ang iyang manghud na si Congressman Coco Nograles.
Kalambuan Dalatanan.
Balik sa atong programa ang Kalambuan Dalatanan. Makikisunan atong isgutan katong deklarasyon ni President Duterte, no? Kalambigit sa ginatawag natong state of lawlessness. Saan si mga
ang Congressman Coco Nograles ato ta si katulong bahin sa atong programa. Huwag atong palapdan atong disgasyon, may karabutan aning state of lawlessness kay matudimo, imong ginasuportahan ang maong deklarasyon. Pero sa laing bahin sa Congressman Coco Nograles, medyo nag-uulpo na uban tungod-bud sa maong deklarasyon.
I don't think there is any reason to be worried about the declaration sa state of lawlessness. Kay hindi man ito first time na gi-declare ang state of lawlessness diri sa Davao. In fact, the last time na naay declaration of state of lawlessness sa Davao was 2003 pagka human sa atong twin bombings of the Davao International Airport and the Sa Wharf. Then President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo declared a state of lawlessness in Davao City, and if memory serves me right, after 1 month gi-lift ang state of lawlessness, no? Mm-hmm. But that time of state of lawlessness in 2003 was the birth of Task Force Davao. During that declaration of the state of lawlessness, ang Davao City felt more secure that naay mga presence of police, increased presence sa police o military sa atong syudad. And that is what we are enjoying right now, na ay mga additional checkpoints manned by both police and military personnel. And I think generally speaking na ang atong community is responding favorably naman. Kita mga taga Davao, if you have nothing to hide, you have nothing to fear. Mm-hmm. Diba? Ang mga negative reaction are from people who are not from Davao. Na hindi nila maintindihan na it is necessary at this point in time. Ang mga concerned na, uy, na state of lawlessness. That's because they're not from here, I believe. So for me, hindi yan issue.
Among na saran nga nasuko ka no sa kining mga nagakatag nga mga istorya nga kuno kining pagpamumbag ituyo kay para dunay basihan ang presidente nga magdeklaro og martial law.
Oh, tinuod na kay do you know the definition of terrorism? Terrorism is defined by all dictionaries that it is the use of violence or intimidation or force to advance one's political agenda. And if people are criticizing na, oh, and si Duterte nag-declare ng state of lawlessness para mag-declare yan ng martial law, yung mga nag-intriga ng ganyan, that is political agenda capitalizing on a violent act here in Davao City. And as a Davaoino, I am very much insulted in statements like those. Personally, professionally, ako nag-iisip ako, those are very terroristic words. Dili na pwede. It is in bad taste and it is questionable. our countrymen, Davaoenos, the community, suffered a shock. And people are putting political color. Walang gipili yan, yung bumba. Do not put political color there. If you put political color in violence, you are a terrorist. So, suko ko. Unfair. And uncalled for. Ano na siya?
Okay. Sa imong pag-ingon nga diversionary tactic ang pagpamumba, no, tungod sa ginahimong counter-terrorism o anti-drug operation sa atong gobyerno, unsa ang buot nimo ipasabot sa mong pamahayag?
Okay. Kay naay man mga tactics sana na pwede i-divert ang focus ng government in an ongoing operation. Mm-hmm. You have to understand that our government is now focused on two war fronts. Mm-hmm. The fight against terrorism focused on the Abu Sayyaf group and the war on drugs. Mm-hmm. So all our police force, all our military force, naka-focus na dyan. And if they hit Davao City, and they did, they hit Davao City, it is possible na diversionary lang yan para mag-spread out ang force. Magbalik sila sa Davao, na ikuha ang mga military, ganyan, ibutang sa Davao para mag-increase ang security sa Davao.
So maluag-luagan sila dito.
Yes. So makalusot sila gamay. But for me, I think we can augment our presence here in Davao. And I think the government has plans to make sure na in all fronts, we will still win those battles. I don't think our police director will stop his campaign against drugs. I think he should stick to his timeline. And at the same time, attend to this bomb matter. Kaya man niya yan. Believe man ako sa kay Bato. Mm-hmm.
Congressman Coco Nograles, buo po ba ang inyong paniwala na ang mga kaganapan ito ay hindi hahantong po sa Marcelo?
Yes, of course. Of course. Because a state of lawlessness allows the president to call upon the armed forces to help. And the purpose is to ultimately stop any need for martial law. Maayo ganin na state of lawlessness eh, para hindi makaabot sa martial law. So I believe that this state of lawlessness is not a step towards martial law, but it is a step avoiding martial law.
Kining unsa ba ang kalahian sa martial law kumpara sa gingong state of lawlessness, Congressman?
Ang short answer, Ana Salz, is the suspension of the writ of habeas corpus, or also known as the suspension of any need to arrest without warrant. So, karon we have the state of lawlessness. I believe that the powers of the president is for him to call upon the armed forces, which includes mga reservist. So ako, reservist man ko sa armed forces, reservist ako sa Air Force. So if I'm needed by the president to come in, then all he has to do is call. Call upon us, reservist, to come in. Reservist ko kay nag-ROTC man ko. Karun, wala na yung ROTC. No? I think ROTC was stopped since 2003. Mga inana, no? Ay, hindi. 2006 siguro. 2006, nag-stop ang ROTC.
Ang atong college, mag-garden-garden na lang. Magtanong mo ba
ang tao? Mais-mais.
Wala na yung military training.
No, but I'll be honest with you, ha. Ako, I am very supportive in bringing back the ROTC program. Just last month, nag-present sa akin ang Army Reserve Command, and they informed us na hapit na mag-senior citizen mga reservists na to. Ang average age of our reservists is already in the 40s and 50s, and that is not good, because in most military practices, you have an armed forces na dapat 20% active, 80% reservist. Karon bali na. You have 80% active, 20% reservist. So we have to build our reservist base. So during times like this, it's a state of lawlessness. Baka merong mga gustong mag-volunteer, magpasok sa reservist program, and you can be able to help our government curb this. You don't need to be part of the violence, but for the day-to-day, you can contribute to our armed forces.
Ako sa Air Force po ko, no? Pareha po min ni
Congressman
Coco. Pero nag-training ako 3 months sa Army Reserve. Anyway,
ako gusto ko mag-retrain para ma-upgrade na ko.
Exercise po.
Exercise po. Apil lang sports.
Apil lang sports.
Oh, pag nag-ano, pag nagbalik ko sa reserve training, I think ang rank ko na maging Lieutenant Colonel.
Si
Mayor Sara is a reservist, ha? She's a Lieutenant Colonel, I believe. So ano, I think it's time to
ako sa rinto lang ko, Sals.
Kung makita ko si Mayor Sara, mag
salot dito.
Salot, John, siyempre.
Anyway, nagpagawas na ang Malacanang Congressman Coco Nog, katong giya, no, sa ilang pagpatuman sa katong balaod ubos sa katong ginatawag na itong state of lawlessness. So, sa po lang yung ikasulti na itong ilang giya na ilang dipatawas?
Well, ang focal point sa ilang guide is the warrantless arrest daw or stay, ano, the conditions when officers can arrest. At the same time, who can arrest? The ones who can arrest under the state of lawlessness are also the military. So usually that's reserved for the police. Now it also includes the military. And ang guide sa who can be arrested is just the same under the revised penal code. So nothing changed there except for the fact na ang military pwede na rin mag-arrest. That's the only major difference in a state of lawlessness and normal state. Whereas sa martial law, hindi mo na pwede kayo arrest anytime.
Okay. Una na tubiyaan ng atong isutan ng naglambigit sa state of lawlessness. Congressman Coco, unsa may mong ikasulti sa atong mga katawhan, no, kalabot sa mga issue?
Don't be alarmed, no? Yeah. Don't be alarmed sa atong state of lawlessness. This is a temporary measure to make sure na ma-clear out yung areas natin, ang communities natin of elements. And once ma-clear out yan, then I am very confident na malilift yung state of lawlessness. It's just the return of the comeback of 2003 na set in place lahat ng mga safeguards and then we can continue living our normal lives, hopefully sooner than later. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid.
Okay, Raph Atuta, sa siguta ng paugnat sa kusog.
Light moment.
Hindi, bugat po ni. This is serious. Sports is serious.
Kiding, gingo na to, mitambong ka sa Osaka top-level sports meeting.
Yes.
Gipimutang sa Philippine Sports Commission, kung PSC, di pala magdugay. Kiding, pabor isa-isa kung unsa ang mga, mayroon na itong nahimong highlights sa maong panagtagbo Congressman Coco.
I have to congratulate our Philippine Sports Commission chairperson, si William Butch Ramirez, for putting together our sports summit. And ang iyang style, consultative. So, tanang mga heads sa National Sports Association, the Philippine Olympic Committee, headed by former Congressman Peping Cuanco. Nandun din yung mga current members of Congress that are part of the Committee on Youth and Sports, including the chairman, Congressman Conrado Estrella. Mm-hmm. And also present was Congressman Mark Sambar of PBA Party List and myself. Nandun din si Congressman Mikey Romero and Congressman Christopher De Venecia, Congressman Cristal Bagat Singh, and other members of Congress were present. Ang among gi-focus sa Sports Summit was the creation of the Department of Sports as well as the creation of the Sports Institute. So what is the best way to go about that Sports Institute? So far, one of the biggest plans is to build the Sports Institute in Clark, in Pampanga. And kung ano yung ano, mga programs doon, yan yung mga input na pinag-usapan dun sa Sports Summit. And this will be an ongoing process. It was a two-day summit, but yung take-home namin na homework, may homework. Yung homework namin is to meet again and get all of the stakeholders together again and present legislation or some orders, executive orders, na draft executive orders na baka pwede i-suggest kay President.
Congressman Coco, kining unsa may kalainan sa gingon nga ginasugyot nga Sports Institute sa PSC, sa Sports Academy, nga mao ni nagunagyot nga plataporma sa PBA Partiles?
It's more or less the same. It's more or less the same. It's the idea na merong institute or academy na nag-focus sa sports sciences and nag-improve sa ating mga atleta. And I think moving forward, it's not just like a college, but it would be more than that. Ang sa PBA party list, gusto natin ng sports academy kasi di ba merong Philippine Military Academy. Yung gusto ng PBA, we want a Philippine Sports Academy. The Sports Institute na gusto ni Chairman Ramirez can be within the Philippine Sports Academy na ginapropose natin or under the Sports Academy or ang